We are actually working on the revival of MAPSA Urban Cooperative Bank, you know, so fortunately we've got the opportunity. It's a wonderful opportunity to work, you know, towards the interest of the people, towards the interest of the depositors and the shareholders of the bank. We see a great scope in MAPSA Urban Cooperative Bank. Unfortunately, due to our unfortunate circumstances, the license of the banking for MAPSA Urban Cooperative Bank was cancelled summer last year. And it's very unfortunate to know that. But unfortunately, you know, since that has happened, there is a lot of, you know, legal angles to it. So basically, our legal team has been working on it closely to make sure that we are able to eventually get this sorted for the shareholders. So there's a group of shareholders who wants us to go ahead and revive the bank, you know. And in the interest of the depositors and shareholders, if you're aware of this, that in the cases of mergers and all of that, you know, there's basically a haircut which has been given to depositors, you know, which is also happening in the recent case of, you know, several banks which are under the process of amalgamation. You know. So what we are looking at is, I can tell you this, with this revival, there is not going to be any haircut to the depositors, so they're not going to lose any money. And the second benefit to the depositors and the shareholders is actually this, that, you know, the bank has sufficient assets. So unfortunately, the license of banking which was cancelled incorrectly. So constitutionally, if you look at, and as per the principles of accounting, the valuation of the assets of, you know, non-banking and banking assets of the bank should have been calculated. Unfortunately, while the license of banking was cancelled by the RBI, by the Reserve Bank of India, they did not look at the actual valuation of the assets which were basically part of the bank.
Story by William Rodriguez for Herald TV.